Okay, let's unpack the Ubu i5 AGV Kits. So, wanna go for the box? Don't cut too deep. Okay, take that one. Okay, so Oliver is unpacking the Ubu, unpacking the control box in this case. So what do we have? We have our extra connectors we requested, which is great. Which we ship for another project, and the films, which is also great. The robot arm cable and the control box cable,
This comes with a 90-degree angle.
which is interesting, which is normally a straight connector. Okay, good. Let's put it on the side here. Okay, let's unpack the top cover. Okay, I'll take this over. Okay, interesting puzzle they have this time on that robot. That's new. Okay, so let's try to find the screws first. Okay, there they are. Plus the tool connector cable and the inspection report. Screws out.
Here, the hinge pendants.
Okay. The screws on the side. Yep, let's put this over. Okay, the hex key.
Mounting the robot arm.
Yeah. Take that around and check what screw hex we have. Okay. So first one's in. The front, and then let's have a look at the control boxes, which we should have two of them. Okay, so we have a power cable for the separate box, which is good. The connection cable between the main controller and the external power supply, and our inspection reports. Okay, so put these over here as well. Okay, so the AGV unit comes with two control boxes, one main controller and one external power supply. Let's take a look at the AGV control box. Okay, that's quite nice. Let's put that one in. Fits beautifully in here. Okay, and then we have external power supply, so we can control the robot arm without the AGV. Good. Okay. Let's put this there. Maybe let's put the robot cable in. Do the power one. So. Okay. power cable in the wall, single phase. Oops, should plug it in properly, mostly. Okay. Then we have an external power line. And then we have here two cables. Be connected to the HV at a later stage. Right now we're using it on the external power supply. That might be a little bit short. A little bit. So here the main power, PE, okay. And we have here main power, and then we have the second power line, which is 24 volt, including PE. Fits only once. Fits in there. Okay.
The teach pendant cable.
Right, do we have a screwdriver? Let's fasten this. So there's one 24 volt line here, okay. I'm not sure what is the plus PE minus system, which we have here.
Interesting, we need to put it between us and see us, or is it?
Let's check for the connector. The main one, no, it goes down. Switch is on. Then we have a main switch which is on. Ah, okay, so we have the top connector is 48 volt and the bottom connector is 24 volt, which makes sense since we need 48 volt for the robot arm and 24 volt for the I.O. system. Okay, this one is plugged in. This one is plugged in. Let's see for the main switch. This one is on and the power button on. Okay, here we go. So we should have our orange light again eventually. This one is white for teach pendant enable, which we have to turn off. And there is no indicator light like we have on the other one. Okay, so we can just turn it on. Okay, let's boot up and then move the robot arm in a little bit nicer position. So this is running the robot arm with external power supply, 24 and 84, 48 volt. And then we will connect it at the later stage to the AGV, since the AGV has both already on board. Okay, we'll pack up some stuff and then we should be done. Looks in, this will break in, and the top cover. Okay, let's use the other box. Good. Booting up. Yeah, not in linkage mode, which is okay. Okay, free drive. Okay, and we are done. Okay, looks good.